Hey guys, so today you and I are going to talk about communication, interviews, and thought processes. So let's get into it. So the question in question was, Frederick, how important is it to clearly communicate your thought process during a technical interview? And the short answer is, it's probably, in many cases, more important than getting the answers correct on the test or in the interview. I would go as far as to say that. Let me explain. So there's more than one occasion that where I personally, and I've also seen other developers, be in the situation where they have failed the technical interview. They didn't meet the time budget or something like that. And they still got the job because they got close enough. And see, that's interesting, because if you can get close enough, in many cases that is going to be just fine. And you're going to find that the manager sees that, well, you can actually code, it's just that you didn't have the ability to solve this specific problem. And that's actually very interesting, I think, because that means that all those hours you spent maybe looking up all these answers to different technical questions and so forth. Well, if you solve the problem, that's great, but you still need the communication skill, because if you don't have those, you're not going to get the job. And on the other hand, if you don't solve the problem and you communicate effectively, you still might get the job, which indicates the thing that I've said a few times, guys. It's not just about your ability to solve code when you're in a technical interview, because you have to remember, it's the same thing as hiring a football player or whoever, right? It's you're not going to hire a individual for your team, even if they're really good, if they can't work as part of the team, because then they're just going to be in the way. They can't win the match themselves, and they might cause disruption, and which may cause problems for the other players. And these players you really need. So it's the same thing here. You do have to communicate clearly, because it's more likely, honest to God, that you're going to get the job if you are transparent and genuine and show a real interest in what you're doing. The fourth thing is that you have aptitude for it, and that's the key phrase I would like you to remember here, aptitude. Now, the aptitude of something doesn't mean that you are a master programmer. It just means that you have shown that you know how to write software. And you can do that even if you don't solve the problem on time. And there's many people who have. And in those scenarios, if you do manage to communicate how your thought process was looking, odds are that your interviewer and the company, they're going to ask you around something along the lines of, all right, so what went wrong with this? Because that's also part of being a software developer. If you made a mistake, or you made a mental mistake, and you get defensive about it, because I've seen people do this as well, and they haven't gotten the job. They have not gotten a second an offer. And they go defensive, and they will say that, no, I wanted to solve this in the most performant and effective way possible, and so forth, and then they haven't communicated effectively with the interviewer. And they haven't been allowed into the next phase, simply because they could not communicate effectively with their potential future coworker. And that's a big red flag, because that's more important to some companies than whether or not you are able to solve a trivia question in a very short time period, which is, I mean, kind of the thing I've said a few times. Guys, the interviewers, well, not all of them, they are not stupid. They're not dumb. They realize this just as well as everybody else, that there are trivia questions that you can go and look up the answers to, and then just copy paste the answer into the exercise and pass the grade. And that's kind of common knowledge that these famous algorithms are around. So when you're doing these sorts of tests, they're not really meant to test how smart you are. Some cases, I will admit that there are some really weird companies out there who treat the interview process as some way of finding talents, which is just the dumbest thing ever. Why the hell are you looking? Why are you trying to find the talent when you're in a position where you're basically just wasting everybody's time? It's not about figuring out if they're smart. That you should have been able to figure out way before they're actually there doing the code test. Here it's about to figure out, just validating your theory that this person is good. And that's usually the best, in the best, usually the way to do that is to give them a challenge that is hard-ish, and some can, and just evaluate how do they deal with this problem? Are they on the right track, or like so forth? And for you as the software developer, I give you the same advice. Treat this process as an opportunity for you not to show off, not to try to to prove that you're some type of genius. Just write the code to the best of your abilities in the way that you most likely would have done in the real world. Because I don't know how many times people have failed due to trying to be extra clever or do things that they would normally not do as part of everyday work, and then they have overcomplicated the thing, and they've got their fingers burned because of that. So what I want you to take away from this is that there are so many factors that play in when you go to a technical interview that there's no way for me to tell you that, oh, you should just focus on this or that. But for sure, your ability to communicate your thought process during the interview is a very important factor. The social aspects is it's a large part of your evaluation. I promise you that. If you don't believe me, go and have a look at Amazon's interview values or Google's interview values. And both of these super companies, and the same thing goes with Facebook, they post people, like, you can go on YouTube today and go and look at something like Amazon's interviewing values and talk to people and listen to people who do the recruiting at these super companies. And it's the same, they will give you the same roughly value system that every single other company has for the most part. And that is that it is important to them that you are genuine, that you communicate, and that you have the right mindset socially on top of your aptitude and ability, in some case ability, to write good software. But this is what I've said so many times. It's equal. I would say the social aspect in some cases are more important to some companies, and some cases, of course, the technical aspects are more important, but you can't dismiss one over the other. So being able to communicate effectively your thoughts around your personal process and how you think about software development when you're in the interview might actually land you the job, even if you don't get the exercise correct, or even if your solution wasn't perfect. So it is a very important factor. You can definitely take that to the bank. I promise you that you can. Have a great day.